Thank you so much for watching. You know, this month I've been talking about a very intimate subject, which is soul ties. Specifically, breaking soul ties. You know, you may have a soul tie, a wrong relationship in your life that you know on the inside it's time to break free. But perhaps you don't know how, or you've tried, but you keep going back to that person. You know, a soul tie is just a connection or a bond that unites you with someone else. Now, the more intimate you are with someone, the tighter the bond becomes. And of course, the harder it is to break free, the more painful it is to break free when you know in your heart you're supposed to get out. You know, I speak from experience. I know what it's like to be in a relationship with someone, actually several people, where you have a wrong soul tie. And I know how painful it is. I was even in an abusive relationship, and everyone would tell me, Terri, wake up, get out of this relationship. But I couldn't get out of it. In fact, stayed with him another year, even after the abuse started, because I could not break free. Why? Because we had memories together, because of the talks we had, because we were very intimate with each other. And I would just look at him and think, I can't break free, not after what we've done with each other. I could not break free. But finally, the day came when I developed the strength on the inside to break free from that wrong relationship. And I want you to do the same thing. You know, Satan will work tirelessly to keep you bound to a wrong person. Why? Because he wants you to miss out on the plan of God for your life. You know, I received so many testimonies and emails and comments on our website about people in wrong relationships. In fact, listen to this one. She said, about a month and a half ago, I finally cut an unhealthy relationship out of my life after 4 or 5 times of going back and forth, leaving him, and then getting back together. I started dating him a little over a year ago, and to make an extremely long story short, over the course of time I dated him, there were a lot of red flags I saw. Now pay attention to that. When you see red flags, when you hear them, when you feel them, when you know that God is warning you, man, that is the first sign, get out. Don't get closer to this person and then make it harder to break free. She said, from this single relationship and choices I made, I fell into sin, felt guilt and shame, was verbally abused, manipulated, felt far away from God. My confidence and my self-esteem decreased. Those are other tactics of the enemy to keep you destroyed, to keep you out of the will of God for your life. She said, I experienced anxiety, depression, insomnia, unforgiveness, mainly towards myself, and pretty much wore a mask on my face, hiding everything that was going on inside. Now think about that. If you're in a right relationship that God has planned for your life, are you going to feel guilt, shame, manipulated, low self-esteem, low confidence? No, you're going to feel the exact opposite. Those are all signs that Satan is working in your life to destroy it. She said, there are things I never told anybody and only brought to God as I prayed and continually read his word. There were so many times I would just drop to my knees and cry out to God as worship music played in the background. She said, it was as if a nightmare was never going to end. The thing is, I completely understand what she's saying, so I'm not trying to sound hard. I'm just saying, let's wake up. Let's avoid this thing before it gets worse. She said, one night I went on YouTube, and I can't remember 100% what I typed, but I think I wrote soul ties, and I clicked on your video. She said, I had never heard about you or listened to your sermons, but that night was the beginning of the road of transformation that God had set before me. I watched each of your videos on soul ties in one sitting, and I started to feel my heaviness begin to lift off of me. She said, as days and days went by, I continued to watch other podcasts and began taking notes and applying them to my life. I meditated on your messages and the scriptures that you referenced. I felt such a connection, and she said, hearing others' testimonies made me feel like you understood what I was going through. Shortly after this, I got the strength to end the relationship. See, that's what you need. You need inner strength that comes only from God's word to help you break this relationship. She said, God started to confirm a lot of things to me about how I'd been so deceived by the enemy. Let me just tell you real quick. Deception means believing a lie. So if you believe a lie, then to you it's the truth. And you might be in a deceptive relationship right now where you think, no, I belong with this person. It may even be an adulterous relationship. And your feelings are trying to convince you, we belong together. I've never loved someone like I love him or her. I'm telling you, Satan is deceiving you into believing a lie. In fact, you know, I'm thankful that Alana wrote in and told us how she was able to break free. But do you know that Satan is so subtle? That's how he works, is through subtlety. He doesn't just come out of a closet with a, you know, a red costume on and a pitchfork and say, I'm here to destroy your life. No, he's very subtle. In fact, one of the ways, and I want you to, you know, be cautious of this, is one of the ways that he works to deceive us is through just connecting with old flames through social media. Do you know, I actually Googled that one time. I Googled Facebook affairs. And I discovered a comment from someone in an affair recovery group, and she said that she realized more and more that connections made through social media and networking blossomed into an affair. She said many times the affairs grew out of new relationships nurtured online, but more often than not, they developed as a result of reconnections with past friends and old lovers. She said another site bluntly says, if you're single, divorced, or widowed, don't look up that old flame. Why? It leads to danger. Researchers interviewed married men and women who rationalized getting in touch with an old love through social networking. They considered it private, harmless, and safe when they hit send. In fact, 62% of the married couples who got in touch with an old flame wound up having an affair for which none of them began that contact with that in mind. What am I saying? That Satan is very subtle. He wants more than anything for you to destroy your marriage, destroy your family network, destroy your self-esteem, destroy your career, the plan of God for your life. He wants you convinced that you belong with this other person. You know, another testimony that I received, it was just so encouraging because it was just helps you realize that you're not alone. You're not crazy. You're not the worst person in the world because you've gotten in a wrong relationship or you're trying to break free from one. You know what? I understand what you're going through, but God wants you to break free. In fact, listen to this. She said, this precious girl was talking about how she was in love with a guy since she was 16, and she kept in touch with him ever so often every year since then. She said, I couldn't figure out why there was this attachment. With all my power and prayer, I could not erase these feelings. She said, he's since married the past 3 years, but continued contact with me, telling me how much he loves me. She said, I went through a serious emotional breakdown 2 years ago, which included 3 days of fasting in order to get me out of this feeling of being so attached to him. I changed my phone number, blocked his emails and instant messages, and I ran from sin. Then we got in contact again through Facebook. She said, I kept trying to run away from sin and not respond to his messages. But she said, she went on and on, she could not break free from him. Finally, she began to listen to messages like this one on breaking wrong soul ties. She began to read scriptures out of her heart. Things like, in my anguish, I cried to the Lord, and he answered by setting me free. See, you need to get the Word of God on the inside of you. So when those memories come, when those feelings come that are trying to keep you locked in that relationship, the Word of God comes up out of you, on the inside of you, and you speak it out of your mouth. She began doing that, speaking scriptures up to break that wrong soul tie. She told me just the other day, the ex-boyfriend contacted me recently through Facebook, and I was able to delete the messages without blinking, without any feelings whatsoever. She said, that is truly the work of God. Thank you, Jesus. Well, I want the same thing for you. I want you to break free from anything that's pulling you back. So I want you to cry out to God. Build yourself up in the Word of God. Make a decision that you will have no contact with that person whatsoever. Truly break free. But let me warn you, you cannot do that without the Word of God on the inside of you, without God coming on the scene and helping you to do this. That's why I wrote this book, Untangle, to give you a plan when you get a text from them and you know you shouldn't respond, a plan when you walk in that room and there he is looking at you, a plan when they're emailing you or they're trying to contact you. You need a plan. So, if you identify with this, I want you to get this book Untangle or get it for a friend that you know is in a wrong relationship. I want you to break free so you can move on with the plan of God for your life without the torment in your mind. So if you're enjoying this, please subscribe to this channel. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. I want to keep you motivated to fulfill your purpose. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week.